talk about my the comet, the my previous company, Rolls Royce logo here. The history of Rolls Royce is when Mr. Rolls and Mr. Royce meet each other in a coffee shop in the early of 19th century. Mr. Rolls is an engineer, mechanic engineer, and Royce is a businessman. And they and two the excellent guy, they when they meet each other, they think that they can do an important thing, the thing will change the world. And they agree that they will start the company together. And at that time in the coffee shop, they decide that the company will name both of them Rolls-Royce. But which one will come first? There are little argument. And after that, they decide to take a penny and decide which one will come first. And right now, the history is Rolls come first, right? And after a few years, they start company. They think that they can make the most excellent car in the world, the best car in the world, and they come out with the product that the Rolls Royce car, and it took a few years to Rolls Royce car become the most excellent, the number one car in the world, the expensive one in the world, and the excellent one in the world. And Mr. Rolls, the engineer, he hit the machine on his car, on the Rolls Royce, is so good, so excellent that it you see when it installed on the car, it's not good enough, and so Rolls Royce that decide that they will jump into the airplane industry. When the First World War, at the time that the airplane industry, it just start up, and Rolls Royce jump into this business, and it just take them a few years to prove that their machine when they installed on the airplane, it work as excellent as they work on the plane. They work on the land, like the car. So the Rolls Royce, they start the second business that in the airplane, they make the airplane. But after a few years, they think that to make the airplane, they have to make a lot of things, make the body, even the seat, the chair, on the airplane they had to make, but it's not that they want. They just want to focus on the difficult part of the airplane. So they decide that they just only make the engine for airplane. So nowadays, the Rolls Royce is just making engine for airplane, and they are the second best, not the first, the second biggest company make the airplane engine in the world. And they start so it means that so my review, they start their car business in 1900, right? And they after that just 15 years they start the business in airplane. It's the World War One. In the World War Two they are need of, after the World War II, they are need in Europe, they need to buy goods from America, the New World. So the goods they buy from America, they travel by ship. So the ship industry at that time, they need a lot of ship. So Rolls-Royce think that their engine is so good, on land, in the air. Right now they think that they good enough to equip on the ship also. So they start the business on the ship. And it's amazing that it's successful like the land and in the air. Right now the ship business, they call marine business in Rolls-Royce is the number one in the world. This slide that it's some picture of the what you see because right now that when you see the plan, right, you don't see that it the Rolls-Royce, but when you see look at some small detail like this engine, you see that the logo of Rolls-Royce there. One thing that because Rolls-Royce they started on three that crazy in the air, on the sea, and on land. On land they find that the car business they very a lot of company want to jump in the car business, so they think that the car business they not a good business, so they show Rolls-Royce car to BMW 10 years ago, and on land right now they don't do that the car business anymore, but they change to make the engine for power plant and for the offshore where they need the very good engine. What Rolls-Royce do the last 2 or 3 years? When from 2008 or 2009 the economy going down, a lot of company very difficult to make profit. But how about Rolls-Royce? As you can see here in 2009, March 2009, and it October 2012, and this one yesterday I copied this picture yesterday, and you see that the share, their share, their price of share in the stock market increased 226%. How come their business, the very huge business, can increase more than 200% when the company is going down? What did they do? And what they going to do? as my understanding, they have their strategy really focused to increase sport. They try to make their product perfect by they fully integrate system. You just imagine that they build ship, right? To build a ship, they need 5,000 parts, and 20% or 30% to 30%, they buy from the other partner, and they integrate it with the ship they produce, and the target of Rolls-Royce, they try to reduce as much as they could. Their target in 5 years, they will increase the percent of the equipment they produce by themselves to 90%. How can they make that? You begin to develop something from beginning, it takes you a lot of time. And Rolls-Royce, a smart company, they don't want to start from beginning, so they acquire the other excellent company. For example, my previous company, it means the company before Rolls-Royce holding, right? They make this product from Norway. They make this one in number one in quality in the world, and Rolls-Royce coming and buy the whole company. So that they have that product to put on their ship. So that number one tragedy of Rolls-Royce is by the order of excellent company. Number two, they because that the economy is going down, so it means that the customer they don't have much money to pay for the new machine or the new airplane, so they set their strategy to invest in development. Right now they have set the strategy of to development the new version of airplane engine in 10 years. They think that in 10 years when the economy is going up and people have the money, they will buy their new products. And the third strategy, they will moving east. Because they think that yes, the market in the US and the Europe a lot of company they buy a lot of things, right? It's only on Asia where the people become richer, they become have they gradual they become rich in very fast, so they have money to buy things, so they invest in Asia. In the last year, Rolls-Royce invest they open a factory in Singapore to make the airplane engine in Singapore, a very huge company there. When Rolls-Royce they invest the in Singapore, one company in Singapore, they contribute to Singapore about 10% of GDP of Singapore. Okay, that's what the Rolls-Royce do. I think it's a great company.